Hey guys, Deathsletter Magic here, and of course the day where I had to spend 7 hours of my life driving was the day that Wizards picked to go absolutely mental. So let's just start with the real fun one today. Apparently, quite a lot of people. I mean, like, I think I've heard of 4 so far, and I don't talk to that many people in the community or get on, like, socials. Well, especially with how busy I was today. But, apparently a lot of people who ordered the Bob Ross All Lands Cool Artwork Secret Lair and said, I don't want the foil ones because I want to be able to play with the damn cards, got the foil ones. In fact, somebody told me they ordered 4 of the kits and got 4 unplayable foil versions. So if you're about to say, ooh, free upgrade, no! They're unplayable garbage that I would be embarrassed to display on a shelf. I think pretty much everybody's on the same page there. So I guess Wizards is already on top of it because they are sending out an email that says, hello, it's me. I was wondering if after all these years you'd like to meet. Oh, I'm reading the wrong one. Hold on. Ah, yes. Hello. This email is to inform you of a technical glitch that impacted your order of Secret Lair's Happy Little Gathering. We recently became aware that some customers who ordered non-foil drops of Happy Little Gathering will instead receive foil edition drops. And some customers who ordered foil edition drops of Happy Little Gathering will instead receive non-foil drops. Okay, that's the first I heard of that, actually. I didn't actually read this ahead of time. I love how they're like, technical glitch. No, it's your own stupidity. I don't think you flipped a binary digit in your system or something. I mean, maybe like an index was wrong and you started counting at 0 instead of 1 or some dumb thing, or you classified 2 things as the same thing, or, you know, okay. But most of the crap they do is just careless employees and careless subcontractors who just do not give a crap about their job. Every time you get like a 1 centimeter miscut card, that is somebody not giving a shit about their job. Trust me, I used to work at a graphics facility. We didn't give a shit about our job either. We would break the machine on purpose to get an extra break. I am not kidding you, about 15 years ago, if you got a SpongeBob book where there was like 4 little SpongeBob things, where it's the sponge things where you like you put them in the water and they grow bigger, and that was like stamped to the front of a coloring book, and his arm was pinched under the heat seal on the plastic overlay, that was us doing it on purpose because we were trying to break the machine and because we thought it was funny. Because we hated our job, it was like 110 degrees in there, we were working on top of a heat press, and about 50% of our coworkers were there on work release from the prison. The rest were sex offenders. I'm surprised Wizards of the Coast didn't hire us to make the damn cards. And I, because I'm Mr. Hard Worker, like, let's just collect that cheddar, work there for 8 whole weeks, actually. I consider that pretty good. Now, while reading this, did you notice the contradiction? It says, this email is to inform you of a technical glitch that impacted your order. As in, it happened. Not may have, not might have, not some people were affected, not a small number of blah, blah, blah. What? No, it's like, yours was affected. You, your order. And then they walk it back in the very next sentence who say that some customers who ordered it, but this 100% impacted your order, as in past tense. Well, make up your mind. Did it or didn't it? All right, so are they going to make this right? Well, I would say yes, but I'm also going to add, tell me if you also think there's a better way to phrase this. They decided to make this kind of like one of those mind teaser puzzle things instead of just telling you what the hell they're going to do. Okay. If you ordered a foil edition but received a non-foil drop, you will receive a foil edition and can keep the non-foil one at no additional charge. That's the one that doesn't curl, by the way. You're welcome. Oh, sorry. Actually, it said, period. Sorry, I misread that. Then it says, if you ordered a non-foil edition but received a foil drop, you will receive a non-foil edition and can keep the foil edition at no additional charge. So they got all these conditional statements, reflexive, you know, swaps of words. It's like, why didn't they just say, if you got the wrong product, we'll send you the right version and you can keep the one you already have? That's gotta be like 30 less words. And now we're back to not making any sense. No action is required on your part at this time. Then how are they going to know who got the wrong one and who got the right one? Are they just going to send out 2 indiscriminately? Who says they won't make the same mistake twice? Who says that they're not correcting one that doesn't need correcting that was correct? That's why I'm thinking that whole, your order was impacted, Like, it was you, 100%. We are certain about this. And then they went to some customers, and then they went back to, like, no action is required. Trust me, we know that we sent you the wrong one. Not if you got the wrong one, contact us. It's like, no, no action is required. We scanned it. It was the wrong SKU, and we sent it anyway. Congratulations. Merry Christmas. And then, P.S., don't hire SJWs at your company. They're going to spend all their time bitching on Twitter instead of doing their job, and we're going to keep screwing up like this. Don't make the same mistake we did. So they actually confirmed the additional drops, because, you know, they're print to demand, are currently in pre-production, which is like code for they haven't started running them off yet. Pre-production is like approving the proof. No, it just, they haven't started running them off yet. Just, can we be honest with one sentence in this damn email? So we estimate that they will be available to ship in 8 to 10 weeks. Ooh, I would have said 6. I think I did say 6 in an earlier edit, but then there was a screw-up, so I deleted it and forgot to say it in the re-record. So, damn, 8 to 10. Keep an eye on your inbox. We will reach out to each affected customer when the drops are ready for shipment. In the meantime, you can check the status of production on our customer knowledge base. Oh, so they'll just be like, nope, not ran off yet. Nope, they didn't get to it yet. Nope, the printing contractor had better things to print. Nope, 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 nope. Oh, now they ran it off. And then, because of course, they put, we apologize for any inconvenience, but as Bob would say, we don't make mistakes, just happy little accidents. No, you make mistakes, and then you, like, bribe people. Remember the uncut foil sheets? At least 97% of people got those. Some of the rest got toothbrushes for some reason. That was weird. If you didn't hear about that, they literally mailed them toothbrushes instead of uncut foil sheets. Because they're so similar. How does Hasbro Fulfillment even have sample toothbrushes? Okay, I'm being a little bit of an ass. I do actually know why they had them. Anyway, but yeah, I guess it's a happy little accident that you're now getting two instead of one. Except now it kind of sucks for you if they got your order correct. I have a feeling this is like a countrywide thing where it's like certain countries got it all correct and other countries got it all wrong. I mean, it was only ran off in English. It's like, either flip the SKU or you don't, but I don't know. I don't know what would have caused this. Honestly, quite a lot of different things could have caused this. So they end with, as always, we are here for you. If you have any questions, you can reach Wizards Customer Service here. Fantastic. So another just screw up that's unbelievable. I mean, if I wanted to shop at a company where they're incapable of, at a basic level, putting the correct product in the correct box and sending it to the correct person, I would just look for all the listings on eBay that come from the port of LA, and the listing was clearly written by somebody who doesn't specialize in English. I don't think I've ever gotten one of those orders fully correct from one of those vendors when I order like 20 items. Same goes for some AliExpress, some Wish.com, I mean, it's just, some people put in the effort and some don't. But then again, you know, language barrier with like what the label says and all that. So yeah, just another careless mistake, another stupid black eye for a company that is incapable of doing anything right, it would seem. So anyway, that's the story about that. I'm sure they'll continue to screw up order after order after order of these secret lairs. If you recall, the last time they sent a blank email with a title that indicated, hey, even though you didn't order the really expensive pack, we're billing you for it. And like I said, the email was just blank. It was sent out in error. So back-to-back secret lair screw-ups. Wonderful. Stop supporting this company. Stop supporting this product. Just stop everything with this crap. Oh, and full disclosure, I do believe that the distribution and fulfillment is actually done by a third party. Now, whether or not Hasbro owns that third party has been hotly debated. I've heard evidence both ways, which, I mean, would make it not a third party, but yeah. So when I say Wizards, I mean, Wizards should have probably hired a contractor that knows what the hell they're doing. Unless Wizards provided them with the wrong SKU and then they just sent what Wizards told them to send. Just saying. I mean, here's how you do fulfillment at an American company where you want it to get done right. Gather up all your interns, clear out one of the conference rooms, and just have a we're putting crap in boxes and double checking it and sending it out today thing, and then just honk honk, back up the truck, go to the post office. Done. You'd be surprised what kind of scale you can do. And at this point, I don't think they're getting more than about 1,000 to 3,000 orders. So that's like a day's worth of work for a couple people. And if you handle it yourself with internal employees who know the product and are less likely to make a mistake, yeah, it gets done correctly. So thanks for watching, everybody, and watch out for the next video. We got a back-to-back double whammy today. I'll see you guys next time.